cycle. Okay, so we have five, no? And similarly, it is most common, no? If you attended project management training, you have seen this, no? We have the initiation process, the planning, no? Then the execution or the implementation, the control and monitoring or the performance, and the close out of the project. This is called the construction life cycle or the project management process group, no? Na sinasabi natin. Okay, now here in this presentation, we have presented the the graph, no? For implementation of a project, no? As you can see, we have here the x-axis or the horizontal, no? Horizontal line is this one. And we have the vertical line referring to the resources.
Wow.
We refer to your cast. Yes, yes, baby. Please turn off your, okay, cost and staffing, no? Or your resources. And this x-axis represents the time, no? For in managing project or the life cycle, no? Now, as we go along the way here, the resources is increasing, no? From initiating, planning, and execution, the resources is increasing, okay? So, ano-ano itong mga resources? Usually, of course, this is just the money, no? Because pag wala kang money, wala kang pambili ng mga resources mo. And that's very essential, of course. And take note that most of your expenses, your cost or resources, you carry, ano, during the carrying out of the work or implementation stage. Okay? That is represented by, and this is true, no? This is represented by this graph. And this is true. So it is increasing. At the here, third quarter, no, on the one third or the last quarter of your execution process, the resources is decreasing. Na naman, nag-decrease na siya because you are already on the finishing stage of the project, no? Finishing ka na, kaya mag-increase ka ng mag-decrease ka ng resources. So yung resources mo may either be wala ka ng konti na lang bibilhin mo ng materials, you will decrease also your staff, no? No? As you go along the close out of the project. So ganun yung ibig sabihin nito. Meaning, as you progress, no, as the project progresses, the F, no, or the F Y is equals to the function of X, parang ganun, no, which is directly increasing as you go along the during the implementation of your project, and decreases as it closes the project here. Okay? So this is just the, ganito yung cash flow natin. So dapat, as a contractor, paghandaan mo yan. Very, this is very essential, no? Gawan mo ng ganito yung project mo, and you will realize, no, the importance of this analysis. Okay? Okay, or during the preparation of your cash flow, no, projection. Okay? All right. So that's it. Okay. Now we go to the initiating process. So anong meron sa initiating process if you are a contractor? So during initiating process, if you are a contractor, no, you have been awarded by the proponent. So you are given with, or the agency at that, a government agency. You are given with a purchase order or to proceed any contract. Okay? So that's it. So if you have all of this, the objective of that is written in your contract and usually told to you by the agency or by the developer. You need to complete the project, no, timely completion of the project. Meaning kung ano yung schedule, if this is a 1-year schedule, 6-month schedule, 24-month schedule, you need to comply with that project. Because that means customer satisfaction as regards to the proponent. Okay? Sinasatisfy natin ang proponent. Okay? Masaya sila if we complete the project on time. Okay? Of course, that's in terms of TCQ, time, cost, quality, and of course, environment, health, and safety. So you need, no? We need to comply with all of this. All right? All right. Then we have the contracts and obligation of the contractor. What is your obligation as a contractor, as stated by your contract? So we're talking here of the basic. Basic lang yung sinasabi natin dito. So of course, you have your planning responsibilities. Okay? As a contractor, no? So it is just the realization now of our contractor here. Listen, no? You have your planning responsibilities. You need to prepare your schedule. You need to prepare your procurement schedule or purchasing schedule. You need to prepare your workers or manpower deployment schedule. Okay? Why? Because you need to complete the project as per schedule. And that is the basis of your, as an engineer, as a project manager, that will be the basis during execution of your project. Now, pag wala ka nito, number one, you are likely to fail because you contractor ka eh. Pero wala kang sinusundan, paano yan? Sa umpisa pa lang, wala na. Wala ka nang sinusundan. Please mute ng ating... paki-mute na lang para thank you. Paki-mute po nung inyong sino po yung hindi naka-mute dito? Makapagal, please. Paka-mute na lang. Okay. Salamat sa naghahang. Okay. So, yun na, no? Yun ang sinasabi natin. Planning or planning responsibility. Sa umpisa pa lang, no? Dapat planuhin na natin ng mga. Excuse me, please. sa mga participants natin, paki-mute na lang nung Zoom para po hindi marinig yung nasa bahay po ninyo.
Sir, mute
ko
yata para
ma-mute yung ano. Ha? Yeah! Sa iyo, sir, yung control, paki-ano na lang kasi hindi ko ma...
Ayan.
Hindi, okay lang.
Once again po, dun po sa ating participants, please po, paki-mute po yung ating microphone. Thank you po.
Ayun. Si Ma'am Makapagal, no, ng Analiza, paki-mute po nung inyong kung hindi man kayo na yun. Hindi pa rin. Yun, na-mute ko na. Sandali, tuloy tayo. Pasensya na po. No? Pasensya na, no? Pasensya na mga participants. Okay, so that's number one. Then, project management. Okay, as a contractor and a project manager at that, we need to have the one of our competency, no? Project management. We must be knowledgeable and skillful, no, in project management. Yung knowledgeable, yung knowledge and skills, no, magkaiba po yan, ha? Tandaan natin, meron kang knowledge, no? Aral na aral ka sa project management pero wala ka namang skills, no, on how to implement project management, it's a failure. So it must be, no, yung dalawa na yan, dapat meron ka. You must have a knowledge and a skills and a skill to implement project management. Okay? So related, project one, number one and number two is related. Of course, related na yan naman lahat, pati number three, project monitoring, na-explain na rin natin kanina. And it is just the control, no, and monitoring. In other words, this is just the performance, no, performance assessment. No, ibig sabihin, sa umpisa pala, nag-set ka na ng mga criteria, then you need to assess, no, if your criteria is namimet ba. No? That is the performance management, control and monitoring. Okay, that's very essential as a contractor. Now, if you have made all this 1, 2, 3, most likely, no, magiging successful yung project natin, and that's yung tinatawag natin kanina, yung business management acumen mo, yung ROI mo, yung savings profit will be realized. Okay? So 1, 2, 3 is very essential, and we must be, as a contractor and project manager must be aware of that. Okay? And of course, the legal and regulatory responsibilities. Now, for the legal compliance, some of this, no, stated in the contract, because some of the legal, say, permits, obligations are being undertaken already by the agency or by the proponent. It depends, no? So the proponent or the agency might say, okay, contractor, you must perform this permit application, no? And all other permits, kami na. Okay? So that's very simple. Okay? But that's only for permits, no? Permits. In order to execute the projects, you need to secure also, ang legal na sinasabi natin dito, ang regulatory responsibilities, is also your compliant, your permits, you as a contractor, your business permits, yung binanggit natin kanina. No, yearly naman, nirenew yan, business permits and pickup license. No? Yan lang naman yung dalawa na nirenew. Pickup and business permits. So you need to secure that as a contractor every year para masabi tayong legit, no? Legit in the performance of the contract or of the project. And of course, number very important, very essential is the health and safety responsibilities. Okay? Yung sinasabi ng ating isang engineer kanina na question, no, Iloilo, very essential. Kailangan, we need to follow strictly the implementation. Strictly, ha? Hindi ito, this is not a joke, no? Health and safety concern of the project. Zero casualty. Lagi tayo dyan. Okay? So, aware as a contractor, aware na ba tayo ng ating mga responsibilities and no, obligation, contracts and obligation? Yes sir, no, alam na namin yan, but minsan nakakalimutan lang namin. So as a construction management team, no, may mga project tayo dito na managed by JAS, we are here to remind, no, that's why we are having this kind of seminar, to remind, no, everyone, contractors, the responsibility, no, we are here to remind. So wag kayong magalit, no, minsan sasabihin niyo makulit ang construction management team. Makulit, no, wag kayong magalit kasi it is our responsibility. Okay, responsibility namin. We are paid, you are paid by the proponent through your billing, we are paid also by the proponent. In order for us to remind all of you as a contractor to strictly follow the implication, the contracts and obligation and the existing laws, because there will be penalties if we are not going to follow, and that will worst, the penalty will be the closure of our project. So dapat hindi kayo magalit or pasalamat pa kayo na nire-remind kayo ng construction management team. Okay? Because, as I said, that is also your obligation. Okay? Okay, maliwanag tayo dyan. How about a thumbs up? Kung maliwanag, kung naintarado ba sa mga contractor natin, how about a heart and a thumbs up? No, kung naintindihan natin. Well, let me see kung maraming magda-heart. Okay? Okay. If you have questions, no, pwede magtanong as basta related dito sa topic muna natin, okay? So thank you, no? So what will be the penalty, sir? Ano yung mga penalties niyan? Oh, to, yung slide na, nag ano na yung slide natin. Okay? So what will be the penalties? Ano mga penalties niyan, sir? Meron, no? Of course, if you are not the following the timely completion of the project, let's say within 6 months, natapos mo ng 6 months and 15 days, there will be liquidated damages. 15 days, liquidated damages kasi nag-overshoot ka dun sa schedule mo. So the proponent or as a CM, no, ang CM kasi is a representative of the proponent. Tandaan natin yan, ha? CM is a representative of the proponent. No, owner's representative ang tawag. Okay? So, we are here to implement what is stated in the contract. And you know naman kung ano yung contract. No? So, that is liquidated damages. Okay? So, make sure na hindi kayo ma-liquidated damages. Let's say, for example, another is takeover and augmentation. The contract says there is a limitation as regards to your percentage of delays. No, clearly stated in your contract. So you have, as a contractor, you have to refer to the contract kung ano ang percentage, certain percentage na ititake over ka na ng proponent. So there is a certain percentage of that. Let's say, for example, the proponent, the contract tells us that at 10% no delay, the proponent most likely will augment or take over your project. So this construction management team is very careful, no? Very careful in monitoring your percentage of completion. And that's why some of you, no, na mga contractor dito, experience na siguro nabigyan na kayo ng notice of construction delays. One notice, 3, 4, 5, no? Construction delays. But sir, pwede naman namin yan, of course, sasabihin niyo, pwede naman kami sir mag-reply, di ba? Yes, of course. You can reply. You can say, pag binigyan ka ng notice of delay, you can as well reply. You can submit a catch-up plan. Okay? This is to submit a catch-up plan, no? That in 1 week time will be, no, or recovering the slippage or the delays. Yes, that's okay. Okay. And the monitoring, the control and monitoring, both by the contractor and the construction management team goes on and on. Okay. But let's say, for example, hindi mo na-catch up. So the proponent, no, as stated by the contract, will take over or augment your project. Okay? Wala kang magawa kasi yun yung sinasabi ng kontrata natin. So the proponent will likewise, sa takeover, the proponent will have its own strategy, no? So we will not discuss that strategy here, but takeover and augmentation proceedings will take effect if you are delayed, okay? For some reasons. Then, of course, if you have any other violations as per contract, there will be work stoppage. And one violation, of course, is the takeover and augmentation, work stop muna. Okay? Work stoppage. Kasi hindi mo na kaya 50% na yung delay mo or 60% na yung delay mo. Hindi na kaya yan. Okay? So as a contractor, sir, anong gagawin namin? As a contractor, you need to revise your schedule kaagad. See, that's why it is very important. The competency of a project manager and a contractor is very important. No? Kaya sinasabi na project management, competence sa project management, eh, automatic, yeah, you have to arrest the problem as a contractor. Submit the construction, revise construction schedule. Hindi yung revise construction schedule na in-extend yung contract, yung deadline. That's not. You need not to extend the deadline. Now you have to compress your construction schedule. Okay? bawal po, no? Bawal ang mag-revise ng construction schedule na in-extend mo yung deadline mo without approval of the proponent. But tanungin mo, sir, can we extend the contract with approval of... Yes, of course, with valid reasons. And one way to extend the contract is you have your valid reasons. Okay? We will not discuss the valid reasons here. Okay? But you have to be... have one valid reason or two at that. Okay? In order for you to extend the contract. There are many possibilities naman eh. No? Just be a good, no? Just coordinate closely with the construction management team, no? And you will be guided accordingly, okay? As a contractor, okay? Then, another is 1, 2, 3. If you have all of these three na hindi ka pa rin sumunod, nako, mamumroblema ka in a government, iba-blacklist ka na ng gobyerno in an agency. In a private naman, in a developer naman, you will be blacklisted na naman. Oh, sayang. Sayang yung effort mo. Okay? Kasi may mga developers na mahirap, no, magpapasok or magpapa-credit sa kanila and yet sayangin mo lang because of your poor performance. Which is that poor performance can be repaired, no, or rectified accordingly. Ang poor performance na yan can be rectified. Don't worry, contractors. That can be rectified. Hindi yan, ano, hindi yan forever. No, that can be rectified. And this seminar and webinar is one of the rectification process. We are raising awareness, no, on how to. Okay? Kaya this webinar, doon sa naka-attend na mga contractor, this is very essential. Okay? This is very important, no, sa inyo as a contractor. And marami kayong mapupulot na mga strategies and ideas. Okay? Just listen and follow with us. Okay? So that's it. So for the penalties. Okay? Oh, question. Clarification. Okay? No. All right. Hindi ko makikita naman yun. Just raise your thumbs up or if you understand, no, or give a heart if you appreciate the discussion. Okay? Okay. Now let's proceed. So that's for the penalties, no? No. Next process is the project planning process. Okay. So this is the top five as a contractor that will be required to you, no, as a by the construction management or by the proponent as a contractor. You need to have, katatlong beses ko nang sabihin at pang-apat na ngayon, construction schedule. Not the top five, no, construction schedule, manpower schedule, procurement, tool and equipment, cash flow projection. No? Pero yung classic cash flow projection, din yung bibigay sa amin yan. That's yours. Aralin mo. But although dito sa construction schedule, meron ka na rin dyan dahil nagpe-prepare kayo ng construction with the S-curve, di ba? So sa S-curve, kitang-kita niya ang cash flow projection ninyo, ang pinoproject ninyo. But that's cash flow projection for the percentage or percent completion of your project. But the cash flow projection here, it depends on you. Yung gastos mo talaga na actual dun sa project ninyo. Your cash flow projection, budget versus your construction schedule, ano, yung actual mo dito, more or less, and your construction schedule. And the difference of that is your savings, no? Sa certain period na yon. But hindi mo pa ma-realize ang savings mo, total savings mo, not until the completion of the project. Now remember this, sa manpower schedule naman natin, it must be in in sync with your construction schedule, no, and procurement schedule and tools and equipment schedule. So yung apat na yan, in sync yan sila, no? Tandaan natin na dyan yan galing lahat yung tatlo na yan. Okay? All right. So and the other one is, meron pang other one, construction occupational EHS, no? Environment, health and safety. Huwag niyong kalimutan yan, ha? That's very essential in a project. Sa abroad, no? kasi we are ano na rin because of the ASEAN integration, no? 10 years ago pa yung ASEAN integration, we are almost catching up with what is happening abroad, no? So you must be concentrated strictly on the construction, occupational, environment, health and safety of the project. Kasi narinig ko minsan when I attended a seminar, a webinar pala sa abroad, that's in project management, and it refers on this, no, health and safety. Nabanggit nila na dito sa Pilipinas na, no, nung pumunta daw sila medyo mahina. Hindi ko alam kung kailan sila pumunta. Mahina naman talaga yung safety pa natin. Okay? As you can see, kahit sa inyo, tingnan nyo sa paligid ninyo, sa mga project ninyo, is EHS implemented? May mga PPE ba sila? Are they following your workers, following PPE? Unless otherwise, dito sa project na, sa JAS, no, project, we are strictly implementing the occupational safety and health, no, protocol. Okay? Pero sa mga project ninyo, tingnan ninyo, eh, sir, okay lang ba yan? Ay, hindi okay yan because the contractor is in violation of DO13, no? Of DO13 of which is under DOLE. Pag nakita kayo ng DOLE dyan, your project will be closed. May nag-report. Let's say, for example, may project kayo, legit contractor, and then the contractor is not properly implementing occupational EHS properly or not at all. At pag may nagsumbong, nako, well, you will be penalized and the worst is your project will be closed. Okay? Because occupational safety and health is very important. Okay? We will discuss further on that. Okay? Then, so ito yung construction schedule. This is just a sample of the construction schedule. No? Doon sa mga engineers natin, mga estudyante natin. Mostly, ang estudyante natin, our attendance represents 30%, no, of our attendance. So that's 30, no? Ito yung construction schedule. You had the duration, the start and end of every activities, okay? That's very simple. This is a simple presentation of a construction schedule, okay? And there are many tools, no, to come up with. You can use project maraming project scheduling tools. Like say Primavera, no, yung P6 nila. So you can use but meron ganito, what is this, you can use Excel also. Okay, bakit merong nag excuse me, sir, paano matanggal? Let's wait. Stop share. Pag mahina talaga sa yan. Okay. Next is the manpower schedule. Okay. Ito naman is a very simple manpower deployment or mobilization plan. Ano ba requirement natin? No, this is for the engineers, for the workers. Ilang foreman, no? Ilang workers, semi-skilled, unskilled, no? Carpenter, and many other. Okay? So, meron ba kayo nito as a contractor? Dapat meron. Okay? Ito yung basis ninyo ng implementation. And of course, if you nakita ninyo kanina, nakita ninyo yung graph natin, yung curve, no? Doon yung ipapattern. So, during execution, dumadami yung tao natin hanggang execution or implementation, then at the third quarter of the construction and implementation, na kumunti na lang, no, yung curve natin pababa ng pababa. So dito rin yan, ipapattern nyo dito. Okay, so this is a very simple lang, ha, hindi mahirap siya gawin, walang mahirap dito sa ini-explain natin. As a contractor, dapat nasusunod natin ito. Okay, gumagawa, and this is very helpful sa inyo as a contractor. Kasi, this is a guide. Guide natin ito. Kung ilang taong i-employ.
It's 3:00.
Gagawin natin or i-employ natin every day, every week, every other week, no, until the completion of the project. Okay? And of course, you can also, from this, you can derive your salary schedule or your compensation dun sa mga tao. Diba? May projection na kagad kayo. Then that projection, as an engineer, you will be reported by an engineer or project manager to the management. The management will align certain funds to that. So ginagawa ba natin yan? Diba? Dapat gagawin nyo as a project engineer or a project manager. Gagawin nyo because that will help your boss. Oh, that will help the top management align certain funds to your project. Okay? So gagawin natin yan, ha? Gagawin nyo yan. So very simple. Hindi siya mahirap. It's just 1+1. Then, of course, you have the procurement schedule. Ano naman tong procurement schedule, sir? Bakit ngayon lang namin narinig yan? Hindi, matagal nyo na ito narinig. Procurement schedule is ano mga bibilhin ninyo. Usually, contractor, no? Kayo, mga contractor. Naranasan ninyo yan. Kung ano lang kailangan, ngayon nyo bibilhin. Parang Jollibee. Kailangan, oh, engineer, sir, kailangan ko ng semento. Kailangan ko bakal ngayon, sir. Pagalitan yung engineer nyo. Engineer, wag ganun. You need to have a procurement schedule. Anticipate mo yan. Hindi pwedeng Jollibee. Eh kung wala kang pera ngayon, paano? Di ma-delay ka na. See? Ma-delay ka na. Kasi ngayon hiningi ng engineer, ngayon din kailangan. No? It's a technique. Actually, it's a technique. Just in time. No? Just in time is a technique in procurement schedule. In procurement is a procurement strategy. But it is not applicable, no, in certain occasions. Kung wala kang pera, madi-delay siya. Just in time. Okay? Pwede naman just in time. Basta alam ng procurement specialist, no? Ng coordinator ninyo, procurement coordinator. Okay, na anticipate niya. Pwede naman just in time deliver agad. But usually, you need to prepare a procurement schedule. So that's very important. Okay? So meron ba kayo as a contractor? Wala pa kami yan, sir. You need to prepare. Meron na kami yan, sir. Yeah. Pero so far sa experience namin, wala pang nag-submit sa amin na contractor for how many contractors that we have for both Amaya and Abido projects and all other projects that, no, wala pang nag-submit ng procurement schedule. Usually sa construction schedule, nadidelay pa, pero ang construction schedule, that's very easy to do. Bar chart lang yan and activities. No? It's very easy. Hindi siya mahirap. Walang mahirap sa ginagawa natin as an engineer. No? Walang mahirap. It's all Excel. Unless otherwise, hindi ka marunong mag-Excel. Pero in 1 week, hindi ka marunong. Second week, marunong ka na yan. Mag-Excel. Okay? Tanda natin yan. Then, another thing is tools and equipment schedule. Ano ba yung mga tools and equipment schedule, tools and equipment natin? Inventory. Nag-inventory ba kayo? Huh? If you're getting ISO certification, yung mga sinasabi ko is an ISO certification, is an ISO quality management system na. If you're going for ISO certification. By the way, Just Construction and Management Consultants and INEUST is ISO certified organizations. So, okay. So yan, no? So you need to have your tools and equipment inventory. Meron ba kayo yan? Para paghingi ng mga project engineer nyo sa site ng halimbawa, mga tools and equipment, meron na kaagad. Now the question is, meron ba kayong tools and equipment inventory? Sir, wala pa kami yan. Paano ba? Madali lang gumawa niyan. It's just a matter of Excel files and you type your tools and equipment inventory. Okay? So dapat meron kayo yan. Then of course, the cash flow projection. How many project engineers here and project managers are submitting their cash flow projection to the top management, to your boss? How many? How many? None? 10? So you need to, as a project engineer and a project manager at that, you need to submit a cash flow projection for your top management for them to align a budget for your project and next activities and next activities, because every activities is necessary for the production of productivity or for the production of accomplishment. to earn or for the earning of earned value na tinatawag natin. So without that, delay ka. Why? Walang pambili, no? You cannot produce earned value if you have no money. If you have no, hindi kayo nagsasabi ng projection. Kasi yung tanda natin as a project manager or project engineer, yung mga amo naman natin, yung mga may-ari ng contractor, marami rin yung iniisip eh. Diba? Marami silang mga negosyo. So tandaan ninyo na makasubmit para ma-align nila, ay next week pala kailangan ko magbigay ng 100,000 sa project ko sa project A. And sa project B ko naman is another 90,000. So, as top management, I would align, oh, ito yung 100,000 next week. Gamitin. Then that 90,000, who knows that 90,000 will produce an earned value of 500,000 pesos per schedule. And who knows that as top management, that 100,000 will produce 1 million worth of earned value. See? Natandaan ko sa amin nung sa Jazz, no, when we have this as a contractor, meron kaming mga project before as a contractor. So pinapasubmit ko yung engineer ko ng ganyan. If I give you 50,000, what is balik sa akin? What is the earned value of that 50,000? Sir, if you give me 50,000, the earned value is 500,000. So, kung ikaw yung top management, you're happy or not? I am happy. Because if I give 50,000, it will produce 500,000. So, did you do that? Did your engineer, no? Kayong mga engineer and project manager do that to your top management? No, sir. Now, starting today, starting tomorrow, you need to do that. You need to project. You need to analyze. That is project or earned value analysis. And saan ba na sa amin yan, sir, makukuha? Of course, dun sa construction schedule and escrib ninyo. Doon yung kukunin. Kaya nga, hindi yan sinasubmit na for compliance purposes. Siguro sa inyo dito, for a government project dito, may mga agency dito, may mga engineer na nagtatrabaho sa government. Totoo ba yung sinasabi ko na yung contractor nyo is submitting a construction schedule and escrib for compliance purposes? Yes. But you know, that construction and escrib with escrib is very essential if the contractor really understands what the purpose of it. That is for earned value. Earned value production. No? Yan ang sinasabi ko. If I give you 100, what will anong return sa akin? That's 1 million worth of earned value, sir. You can build 1 million na agad if you give me that 100,000. Of course, that is just an example sinasabi ko. But that is the reality. No? Hindi nyo pa to na as a contractor siguro dito, yung mga contractor nagtataka. No? But after this webinar, tingnan nyo yung sinasabi ko. And it's true. It will help you a lot as a contractor, as an owner, as a principal. Okay? So that's it. Well, of course, safety management system. Remember, this is very essential and this is very costly if you are not attending this very much, the safety management system, kung hindi nyo ito binibigyan ng pansin. Why? Bakit, sir, costly yan, sir? Ano ba meron dyan? Eh, costly yan kasi what if may namatay dyan? What if may nadisgrasya dyan? See? Halimbawa, everyday may nadisgrasya kang tao, pinadala mo sa ospital, magkano gastos? Saan mo kukunin yun? That's why safety management system is very essential, no? Kaya nga merong cost kayo kasama sa seminar ninyo as a contractor. Okay? Hindi nyo lang na-realize 'yan kasi wala pang na-disgrasya, pero pag may na-disgrasya 'yan, no, malalagot ano 'yan? Lumalulugi din kayo. And the worst of that is kansilahin pa yung kontrata ninyo. Kasi you are not strictly following the rules and regulation of Department of Labor and Employment as regards to DO-13, which is you are familiar with, no? O yung occupational self and safety na 1030 na sinasabi ng isang engineer natin dito. And the IRR of DO-198 No? Parehas lang sila yan. Pareha lang yung mga laman yan. If you're familiar with that document, no? Or department order. Okay? So, safety and health is very essential. Okay? Admit. Then, okay, question. Oh, pause, ano muna tayo? Question muna tayo. Okay? I need you to scan, no? Paano muna? I need you to scan the question, pero wait. Run ko muna yung question. Okay. Okay, the question is now running. You scan the code. Scan the code. No? And let's say, sandali ha. Para makita ninyo, I stop muna. Stop ko muna. Then I will share something. Button here. Okay, share ko to. Zoom. Okay. Advertise muna tayo. Pahinga muna. And then, question. Share ko. Share na. 10%. Okay. Here is the question. Okay. Yan. Ito, may tanong. As a contractor, is assignment of engineers or engineers at that at site really necessary? Okay. Sige, sagot kayo. Tingnan natin. Lahat na sagot, tama naman eh. Depende naman sa inyo yan eh. Pero titingnan ko lang, titingnan natin kung gaano ka-importante sa tingin ninyo as an engineer, as a contractor, as a professor, as a student, kailangan ba talaga ang wala di, yeah, kailangan ba talaga? So, yeah, 6 pa lang sumagot. You scan the code here. Pero kung hindi nyo ma-scan, you join at slido.com, you type number 1681 and you will have and you can join na the questions. No? Scan the code if you have the ano dito? Cellphone through Viber or yung mga bagong cellphone through camera, meron na yan. Then if you're using your laptop, you join at slido.com, then type 1 or Y681. Okay? 16 ang sumagot pa lang. So I'll give you one more minute. 27. You are 97, so 29. Kahit 50% lang ang makasagot, titingnan natin. Tingnan natin kung may question sila. Please join. 90%. It's okay. 7. It's okay. 41. Yes. More. Please join. As a contractor, is assignment of engineers, no? At site really necessary? Yes, it is a plus. Contract requires it, no? It's okay. As an owner, I can manage naman eh. Plus, I trust my foreman. Okay. Maybe I am not decided yet. I have no budget. That's why. Then, I have other options. Okay. Yan ang mga choices natin. Okay. What else? 47. And counting. You are 96. No, yung iba malis na. Pero yung iba siguro hindi naka-join sa yan. Marami pa tayong pag-usapan. Okay. 49. More. 1 minute. 1 minute more. I will close it at 3:16. 30 seconds. More. Please scan. No? Or join at slido.com and type Y681. 51. Thank you. 51. And 7 seconds, 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, stop. Okay, so 86%, no? 52 participants, siguro. Okay na to kasi 100 tayo, so 50 plus. So 85%, you know, tells us that yes, it is a plus, contract requires it. And there are 10%, no? It's okay, as an owner, I can manage. Plus, I trust my foreman. Siguro yung owner dito, engineer, kaya ganun, ano? Then my 6% na maybe, I am not decided yet. No? Then 0 for I have no budget. And 0 for I have other options. Okay. Ay, ba't napunta dun? Okay, so ganun, ano? So, many of us tells, oh, tama naman, ang pinaka-norm dito is, yes, you have to have a contract, an engineer or a project manager at site. No? Because other than that, the contract requires it. Most contract told us or states that you have to assign a competent, no, a competent engineer at site or a supervisor at that. Hindi sinabi ng kontrata, sinasabi ng kontrata, competent talaga. Hindi siya naglagay ng ibang objective, ay adjective, competent. Kasi ang competent, sinasabi ng competent, yun nga, mayroon siyang competency, yung sinasabi natin kanina, project leadership, no, business management, strategic and business management, acumen, and what else? project management, skills, and knowledge meron siya. Okay? So it is very essential. Although, if you are an engineer at ikaw din naman yung owner, pwede din naman. Okay? It depends on your project. If you're managing, siguro mga small projects, let's say, a few, 10 units or housing units, but if more than that, siguro, kailangan mo na ng engineer. No? Kasi, ikaw, owner, marami ka nang gagawin, marami ka nang okay, marami ka nang transactions. Yes, it is a plus. Contract requires it. Okay? So, that's it. Thank you. So, for the 55 na nag-participate, thank you. And for the 40 plus, 42, no? Next time, join kayo. Oh, wala kayo dyan. Ha? Joke na. Sige. And share ko na to. Any questions so far? Any questions? Comments? Oh, none yet? Okay. Nandito pa ba kayo, sirs? Okay, about a thumbs up. Thumbs up if listening. Okay. All right. Ako dun sa nagtatanong na may certificates to. Yes, we have certificates. It will be given to all of the participants, okay? Okay, let's proceed. Now, we are here on the third phase, no? Third phase na tayo ng ating process construction process or the construction execution na, no, control and monitoring. So hinalo ko na. All right. So during construction implementation, the first thing you should do as a contractor is to attend the project kick-off meeting. No? Now, as a construction manager, you need to conduct a construction kick-off meeting to all of your contractor. Do not forget this because this is very essential. Bakit, sir? Kailangan yan. Yes. This is now the time that you have to lay down everything to your contractor, and that the contractor, it is now the time to clarify everything before you execute your project. Okay? So that is the most, this is the most important, sinasabi niya, the most important tool for success of the project. So you guys, are you guys conducting a kickoff meeting? If not, you have to conduct. If yes, very good. No? Now, during kickoff meeting, the construction management team lays down, no, the requirement of the project that will be submitted by the contractor while execution is ongoing, because it is what? The basis of the construction management team of continuous audit. I-audit kayo as regards to your document na sinasubmit. What are your documents? Construction scape, procurement scape, aside from the plans and specs, no? The contract, the plan specifications. Aside from that, yung mga sinasubmit mo, that will be the basis of audit ng construction management team. So, musunod ka ba sa construction schedule mo? Diyan, iti-check ng construction management team. So, musunod ka ba sa manpower schedule mo? So, musunod ka ba sa purchasing schedule mo? Nire-remind lang kayo ng CM if you're not. Bakit? Because the CM and you has the same objective, which is the timely completion of the project. Sinasabi ng CM, oh, delay ka na. Ibig sabihin, hindi mo ma-achieve yung timely completion of the project mo kasi delay ka na, kaya ni-remind ka ng CM. Ni-remind ka ng CM na, oh, kulang yung tao mo, contractor. Kasi ikaw naman ang sabi na magdalagay ka ng ganitong tao and yet yung nilagay mo kulang. Okay? So, paano mo ma-achieve yung objective mo kung kulang yung tao mo? Then, purchasing schedule. Sabi niya sa purchasing schedule mo, bumili ka na ng materials mo, bakal, semento on Saturday, but yet Saturday na, wala ka pang nabili. So sinabi ng CMO, oh, contractor, sabi ng procurement schedule mo, bibili ka, wala ka pang nabili, niremind ka na naman. So that's it. That is the purpose. Remember, you have one objective ng construction management team. And that is, I repeat, timely completion of the project. For government, kahit anong project yan, mapapa-government, mapa-project, mapa-private project. Okay? Yan ang purpose ng construction management team. Bakit dyan siya sa site? Okay? So yan ha. Tanda natin yan. Now, in the event, no? In the event na may mga special or emergency meetings na nangyari because merong nagawa si contractor na kakaiba. Meaning, there are non-compliances. Contractor, if you are given non-compliances ng construction management team, it's because something is wrong during your execution. Maybe you are not following the plans and specification. Maybe you are not following your construction schedule. Maybe you are not following something that is relevant to the project. And that is your own document that you are not following with. That's why you are issued with non-compliance. And what you are going to do? You have to respond immediately. Okay? You need to respond immediately if issued with non-compliance, NC. Because if you are in an environment of ICE, ISO, or ISO environment, non-compliance is a negative for quality management system. Okay? And makakatulong din sa'yo pag wala kang non-compliance, tuloy-tuloy lang yung trabaho. No, it will affect your performance And that will be positive performance, right? For control and monitoring na tayo. Okay. So take note of that. As emergency meeting and a special meeting will be held. Okay. Next, toolbox meetings. Now, toolbox meetings is conducted for safety purposes and quality purposes. Just to remind the contractor that this is, no, what we are going to do and what it's not and what it's not going to do. And what will be going to do. So toolbox meetings, okay? So actually, ginagawa naman natin yan na for those contractor na hindi gumagawa dito rin, kailangan din ng mga workers natin exercise, no? Before going to work. Reminders to properly PPE, no? Pag gamit ng wastong PPE, no? Properly, okay? That is the purpose of toolbox meetings. All right. Then, of course, we need to, no, as a contractor in a construction management team, we need to have quality initiatives just in case, no. Quality initiatives are initiatives for the improvement or continuous improvement, no. I'm talking of continuous improvement, na naman, for the workmanship quality, no, ng mga contractor natin, ng mga workers natin. So we have this implemented, no, and yung inventory of skills, no, trade test. Ito is huwag kayong as a contractor, huwag kayong maantag dito, magalit ba tawag doon, or huwag kayong mabigla kasi trade test para sa inyo din naman yan. What? Bakit? Kasi may mga tao kayo diyan na nagsasabi, "Ay sir, carpintero ako sir, mason ako sir." And yung rate ba nila, 'di ba? Yung bibigay kayo ng babayad kayo ng sweldo kayo ng rate na malaki dahil mason nga sila, mga carpintero nga sila. And yet, nung tiningnan inspection ng construction management team, ng quality engineer, ay maraming mali. No? So, nag-rectify na naman kayo, nag-rectify. You know, what as a contractor, rectification is 3 to 5% or 7% of your cost. For every 1 million that place around 30,000 of your contract, no? For 3%, kung 7% pa, maybe 70,000. Malaki. And even more than that, di ba? Yan ang purpose ng trade test. Plus, baka niluloko kayo ng mason, carpintero, hindi naman pala, nagbabayad kayo ng malaki. See? So sa mga proponent o sa mga owner ng contractor principal, that is very essential. Trade test. Plus, it will give you the benefit. No? Magagaling yung gumagawa. So yung rectification time, maiksi or none at all. Walang rectification. Plus, the excess. Yung mga semento na natatapon, no? Wala. Kasi magaling siya na mason. Okay? That's, pag hindi magaling, maraming semento. Nakikita niyo, mga semento, tapon, dami. Nagpa-plaster, makapal. Tingnan ninyo. So that's the purpose. So savings nyo yan, actually. Kaya huwag kayong mabigla sa CM pag nagpa-implement ng trade test because that is for you naman as a contractor. Kung magaling lahat. Then we have the another initiative is the patok yung pre-orientation, no? Pre-activity or orientation as regards to quality and safety. Patos-patok. I-inform mo ng workers paano ang quality, ang engineer na bagong pasok, yung workers na bagong pasok, no? Ano ang quality dito? Ito yung quality dito. Kasi karamihan yung retention, yung mga resignation ng mga workers, mabilis. So yung patok-patos, mabilis. So that's initiative. No? Mga initiatives. Are you conducting that initiative? And not only as a CM ang gumawa ng initiative, kayong mga contractor din in your own as an sarili ninyong bakod, saka sarili ninyong organization, you conduct your own initiatives as regards to quality. No? You need to, because this is a competitive world, you have to have your own, no? your own quality initiatives as regard to them. Now, what I'm saying is, mga sample lang to, and this is implemented in our project. No, doon sa mga hindi project namin o nakikinig dito, you can have your own, no, or you can adapt this, but this is more of quality and it is just the same. No, what at the end, ang end result ito is a customer satisfaction with the proponent. No, that's the ultimate lang naman na goal natin. Ha? Because we have the services is the customer satisfaction of our client. Okay? Right. Any question? Clarification? Please turn off your mic. Then, yung mga participants natin, please. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Then, of course, we have the construction procedures, no? Or the method statement or the methodologies. Sometimes methodologies is given by the supplier. If you supply, for example, a building system, or the methods will be given by the contractor for rectification process. No? Anong rectification methodology ang gagawin mo for, say, for example, weldings, no? Or for rectification of welding works, or rectification of wala sa level na mga walls, or rectification of an electrical system na hindi nasa specs, no? Ano ibig sabihin ng electrical system na wala sa specs? Let's say, for example, we are you are, as per specs, you have to use a PVC conduit, no? Electrical PVC, as per specs, ha? Pero as per actual, nagamit ka ng ano ba tawag dito? Yung PB, yung electrical conduit na hindi siya PVC, kundi yung ano ba tawag, naka-roll yung, no? So you have to have a methodology for that. And all many others, no, na mga methodologies dapat magbigay si contractor or humingi si contractor for that matter ng mga method na bago pa lang i-implement. Pero kung luma na, there's no method because this standard na yan eh. Okay? Next is, of course, construction methodology. Yeah, methodology. Wait. Yun ang sinasabi ko. Another question. Maraming question ah. Para hindi kayo mantok. O, yung scan ulit ng code natin. Say, for example. Sandali lang, may question tayo. Oh. Okay. Let's play. Yan. Scan, please scan the code. And the question is, ito yung question. And share muna natin. The question is, dyan na naka-post na yata. You scan the code. Yan. Okay. So why is quality very important in managing a project? Okay, give me your answer. No? As many as you can. Okay. Why is quality? Kasi quality na tayo mamaya. Kaya ako tinanong. Alright. To avoid rework. Very good. Galing. Magaling yung sumagot nito. To avoid extra cost. Of course, kung may rework ka, may extra cost ka. ensure safety. Yes. Client satisfaction. Very nice. Project success. Top level. Avoid punch list. Yes, this is the ultimate objective. Avoid schedule impact. Yes. Client satisfaction again. Ay, nabanggit ko na. Avoid schedule impact. O, 6 pa lang ang sumagot. We are 95, please. Sumagot kayo para ma... Yeah, 7, no? What else? We are 95, kahit 50% ang sumagot. Boys, schedule impact. Okay, what else? Make your attendance participative, no? Or interactive, no? By answering the question, okay? This is the purpose of the webinar, no? For everyone, no? To join and be interactive as possible, no? It is just like submitting your construction schedule and leave it there, no? Kung hindi kayo nag-join. So, as an engineer, the character na dinevelop natin dito while attending the seminar is agility, no? Agility, anticipation, no? And character na dapat walain na natin yung mga traditional, no? Character natin as an engineer and project manager. No, traditional, yung traditional natin na panjing-banjing lang, hindi na pwede yan ngayon, no? Magagalit na si boss niyo niyan. So, and then, pag may mga questions, may mga hindi kayo maintindihan, clarification, you have to raise questions, no? To the construction management team and to your boss, no? To clarify the objective. You need to have the objective. No? Clarify. Clear ang objective. Client satisfaction, top level. Yes, to avoid the work that is to 26. No, I need 30 more. Sayang, no? We are giving certificates and yet no, certificates lang yung hinahabol niyo pala. Join kayo sa ano natin para hindi kayo antukin. No, avoid failure. Yes, successful project. Output 29, customer satisfaction top level, very good. Self satisfaction. Ano kaya itong self-satisfaction? Yeah, as a project manager, pwede. Self-satisfied, no? Of course, tama naman yan na satisfied ka pag maganda yung quality mo kasi you have all the recognition, no, of the top management. Recognition of the top management. What else? Wala dito, wala pa yung recognition of top management. What else? Managing a project, no? Quality, no? More projects, of course, no? Pag quality yung project mo, sustainable. Your company will be sustainable. Okay? Yes, you have to build trust to future clients. What else? No, 37. More. Okay. What else? Ensure the safety, client satisfaction. Ensure better portfolio. Yeah. Durability. Very good. No? Durable. Oh, siyempre naman. Pag quality, durable yan. What else? Gain trust from the client. Yes, of course. Top level, no? To be sustainable yung company. Kasi ikaw pa rin yung kukunin ng ano. You gain trust from the client. Performance. Measurement. Yes, it is one of the performance measurement quality. What else? 41. 9 more. Para ano na tayo? Let's proceed to ensure quality. You have 20 minutes more na lang before 4 o'clock. What else? Guys, come on. I know. Marami pa kayo dyan bala. Excellent standards. Yes, very good. Ano pa? Avoid interruptions, of course. Kasi wala nang reward, kaya wala nang interruption. What else? Implies competency. Yes. What else? Hello, hello. 42. Asan na yung 60? Ano plus? Yeah, acceptance. Easy acceptance. Work quality. Cash flow, savings, yes, top level, savings, marketable at all. Avoid wasting time. What else? Successful time record project completion. Meet quality expectations, yes, it's a criteria. 44, 6 more. To para 50%, no? Yung sumagot. Port 45. Oh, yung iba pa. Yung cellphone nyo. Gamitin nyo na yung cellphone yung bago. Scan the code and answer the question. Okay. Scan the code and answer the question. What else? 49. Oh, one more. Para tapos na. Excellent standards. Avoid future structural problem. Ah, malamang structural engineer yung sumagot nito. Tama naman, no? Kung may quality yung structure natin, eh, wala tayong problema. That's why we need to follow strictly the plans, no? And specification of or the structural plan specification to improve manpower skill, okay? Yes, that is for the trade test, no? The inventory of skills natin. That is the purpose, to improve manpower skills. And smooth flow of turnover, yes. If we have zero punch list at the first inspection, no? Tama yan. Okay, 52, let's stop. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, now let's go back to our slides. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, next. Now, okay, since we already knew your ideas about quality, I am presenting to you, no, the basic, no, quality framework in construction implementation. Okay, so for us, of course, we have the work. If you have the work activity, no, before you start your the execution of a certain activity or certain item, you need to submit, no, the permit. Okay. Work activities. So what are these work activities? So alam nyo na yan as a contractor, no? Before you start, you need to submit work permit. So hot work permit for welding works, of course, no? And the project inspection permit and method statement and many others, no? Before you start your activity. So your project inspection request, may mga forms yan that is called the quality assurance forms, no? Concrete pouring permit, ano pa? At marami pang iba. Concrete pouring lang yung na-recall ko. Pero marami yan. May mga staking and layout pa before yung mag-umpisa, no? Turnover of muhon. Kung yan kayo, kung bahay ang gagawin niyo. For ano naman, for mga road construction agency, may meron din sila yan. May mga forms din yan, QC forms or method statement. Okay? But this is the principle, no? Work activity. Then after that, the construction management team as representative of the agency or the proponent will conduct quality assurance, no? Quality assurance is more on the process. So, kung anong ginagawa niyo, quality assurance niya na yan, inspection niya, if you follow na the method statement that you submitted, the standard, no, for a certain activity or the plans and specification, let's say concrete or laying of rebars, are you following the size of rebars, the spacing of rebars, no? Are you following the, are you putting the, before concrete pouring, you are putting the concrete spacer, no? Parang ganyan. That is just one example. On many other, no, it's as stated in the work permit or in the project inspection request. So quality assurance is, no, a process, no. Sa process pa lang tinitingnan na ako may mali. So process, no, prevention. Kasi hindi mo siya bubuhusan kung may mali. Uulitin mo muna. Kaya sinasabi ng inspector, no? Uulitin mo, you rectify this one. Palitan mo yung bakal kasi you are not following the spacing. You are not following the size of the bakal. You are not following the grade of the rebar. Grade 40, grade 60, grade 30. As per specs, as per plan. So you remove, no? Why? Because that is stated by the structural engineer. And it will affect the structural integrity of the structure if you are not following his provisions, huh, as per structural plan. That's why that is very important. Quality assurance. Now, cleared? Yes, cleared na for quality assurance. Of course, bubuhusan mo na yan. So pag buhos, after the buhos, there is now the quality control. Kasi may buhos ka na eh. You conduct test results. Yan naman ang product detection. Sa test result, malalaman. Kasi quality control eh. Tapos na. After the fact. No? After the fact. Okay? So that's why, kung hindi kayo sumusunod pa lang sa quality assurance and you proceed on activity, say nagbuhos kayo, the contractor or the proponent or the inspector of the proponent being the representative at that will have the right, no, na ipa-backback niya sa inyo yung binuhusan ninyo na hindi na inspection, hindi na quality assurance, because something is wrong, no, something is wrong. Kaya tandaan ninyo yan, mga contractor, ha, you should more especially sa government, no, maraming mga ganyang nangyayari. Pinababakbak yan. Yung mga pavement na hindi pumasa sa quality control. Ganon din sa private, no, pag hindi kayo, pag hindi pa na quality assurance at dumiretso kayo, yan ang mangyayari. Why? Because tandaan natin na, let's say for example for a developer, yung mga bahay dyan is binili yan. No? Yung mga bahay natin is binili ng mga kliyente ng owner. Dugot pawis yan eh. So dapat million-million yan ang pagkabili. So dapat yan, gagawin niya ng tama. Kaya andyan yung construction management team as owner representative nga. To oversee that. At pag hindi kayo gumawa ng maayos, pinababakbak yan. So, kung ako sa contractor, sumunod na lang. Wala namang problema para maiwasan. Kasi, Bakit sir, pag dumiretso na lang kami, wala naman. Papagalitan kami ng proponent. Yung proponent ang magagalit sa amin. Because we are there para bantayan yung kayo o trabaho. At pag hindi kami nagbantay at nalaman ng proponent, useless kami. That's why. Kaya ito yung sinasabi namin. Dapat maintindihan ninyo. Okay? Pwedeng ipabakbak yan pag hindi na-inspection at tumuloy kayo sa isang trabaho. Very simple lang naman yan. This is just forms. No more, no less. You are not computing calculus. You are not computing structural design. Di ba? Structural analysis. You are just preparing fill in the blanks. And it is very easy. The forms is very easy. It is like fill in the blanks. Wala nang ano yan eh. You are just putting your mga check muna lang yan eh. You check. You type your name. You put your name, your contractor's name, your project, your date. Then you check. You sign. Tapos na. That is very simple. Kaya nga yung forms, sinisimplify na lang eh para mabilis siya. Pero pag hindi nyo pa nagawa at naibigay kaagad sa CM, yun ang mangyayari. Ha? So that's why this webinar is very essential for in raising awareness is as regard to quality control or quality assurance and quality control. And I hope you understand, okay? And this is standard for all government projects and private projects. Unless otherwise, kahit yung project ninyo doon sa kliyente ninyo na individual, gawin ninyo yung tama ang proseso. No? Para naman garantisado yung no shortcuts. Okay? So quality assurance that's defined by ISO, no? A part of quality management system focused on providing confidence that quality requirement will be fulfilled. So, process-oriented. Proseso pa lang. Sinisita na. Ini-inspection na. And that is quality assurance. Okay? Ina-assure yung quality. No? At pag nagawa, tama na kaagad. Pag hindi nagawa, may mali. And quality control, no, as per ISO, a part of quality management system focused on fulfilling quality requirements. Tapos na. After the fact. So quality control. That's why we need tinetesting natin. We can just testing. Testing on concrete, testing on welding, no? Testing on all others na kailangan i-test. Hollow blocks, no? May mga testing. And all other, mga PVC pipes. Ay, PVC pipes, yeah. At mga RCP pipes sa government, no? Tinetest yan. And that is quality control. When you heard testing, it refers kaagad to quality control. Yeah. At yung, let's say for example, sa mga bahay naman, tapos na. After the fact na eh. Kaya quality control din yan, nagpa-pants list. That is quality control. Tapos na. After the fact. Kina-quality control na lang kung may mga defects pa. Hindi na siya tinetest, kundi through visual. Okay? So yun. Okay? That's quality control. So alam nyo na yung difference. And this is more of that. QC versus QA. Yan. Quality control, product, no? Focused on product. Quality assurance, process. Reactive, no? Quality control. Kaya nga, sa punch list, reactive tayo. Sa quality assurance, proactive. That's why process-oriented. Pag may mali, proactive repair agad. Para hindi na magkamali during quality control. Line function, staff function, find defects, quality control. You find defects. Quality assurance, you prevent defect. You assure quality. Yeah. Quality control testing and quality assurance, quality audits. Okay? So that is, alam nyo na ngayon, ha? Yung difference ng quality control and quality assurance. Okay? So yan, naliwanagan na kayo. Reports. For reports naman, no, daily activity reports is required for the contractors. So POC report and all other reports is by the CM, okay? By the construction management team for control and monitoring of the project. Daily activity report, if you are familiar with, is very essential for the contractor. I guess yung mga i-highlight ko lang yung daily activity report, no? But sa daily activity report, kompleto to. Meron siyang daily activities, material, manpower, issues and concerns, POC, report, every day. And kung ako yung owner ng contractor, this is what I require with my engineer. Engineer, give me the report to me, the daily activity report. You reported to CM, site CM. Pares lang naman yan. Especially the POC. Yung POC na to, tinatawag natin na percent of completion or your accomplishment percentage actual on-site versus your plan as per your construction schedule. Okay? So, di ba maganda? So, hinihingi nyo ba ito sa engineer ninyo? Kasi gumagawa sila. Hindi pa. Hingin ninyo, as owner kayo, hingin ninyo sa kanila. As an engineer naman, fill in the blocks lang naman yan, engineer. No? You know naman yan kung paano. Alam mo yung manpower, alam mo yung materials, alam mo yung activity based on your construction schedule. Okay? So you write it down. Walang memorization. Just actual. Kung ano nangyayari and fill in the blanks. Oh. Hindi kayo mahirapan, no? This is required, no? This is a requirement. This is a requirement. Sasabihin niyo, maraming useless. Hindi siya useless if you understand you understand the objective of the daily activity report. That's why it is for you, no? To determine the percent of completion of your project, and if you are delayed, you have to take action. That's why sa baba meron pa siyang issues and concerns, no? Issues and concerns may refer to your health and safety or to your percent of completion or to your manpower. So you report there the issues and concerns, and you are required also to have a corrective action. Di ba? Gagawa kayo ng issue, dapat may corrective action pa kayo. Gagawin nyo rin yung sakot. So that is trabaho talaga ng engineer. Ganun ang engineer. And that is international standards. Pag pumunta kayo ng abroad, yan din yung gagawin ninyo. And this is familiar na kayo. Kaya nga, because you are working in an ISO organization. That's why. Okay? Pasalamat kayo, you are working with an ISO organization and what you are implementing is based on ISO standard, and you as an engineer na makapag-benefit niyan as a project manager or as an engineer, because that is international standard. Kahit saan ka pumunta sa buong mundo, ISO certification, environment, ISO environment, parehas lang. Iba-iba lang yung itsura ng activity report. Iba-iba lang yung POC report. Iba-iba lang yung QAQC report. Gets nyo? Iba lang yung form na ginagamit. Pero the principle, no, and the reporting method is just the same. The process. Reporting process. Okay? So tanda natin yan. Okay? Next is, of course, tapos na natin. We need to turn over the project. Okay? The turnover na natin yan. We have to project close out, no? And turn over. So project close out, of course, you have your inventory as a contractor. You perform your inventory, your tools and equipment inventory. You perform all other inventory you have to perform it, or documentary inventory. Kasi tapos na kayo eh. So you have to do that, no? As a contractor. Do not forget. Kasi sayang. Sayang yung mga tools and equipment ninyo na andun lang sa site, na iiwan ninyo, tapos aalis kayo. See? Sayang. Then, after that, for CM naman, of course, their project closeout na, we of course conduct a financial closeout to the developer, to the proponent. Okay? As a construction management team naman. Okay? Then we turn over everything, turn over of documents, lahat ng documents as per ISO standard, ito turn over sa proponent. Let's say, for example, ang dami niyan, no? Marami yan. Hindi na natin banggitin dito. Then, sa turnover, take note.
It's 4 o'clock.
As a contractor, you need to trigger. What is the triggering of turnover of the project? You need to write a letter of turnover to the to CM. Tandaan natin na documentation or technical writing is 100% essential in dealings with project implementation. And as an engineer, no, sabihin man natin na hindi tayo magaling sumulat, eh ganun talaga. Susulat tayo. Project implementation. Technical writing, by the way, is being taught in the university, right? Noong nag-graduate kayo as a CE, as an architect, mayroong technical writing yan na tinuturo na subject. So, come, ba? Well, anyway, hindi man tayo magaling, but we need to trigger a letter of turnover to the site CM or to the proponent. So, proponent, I would like to turn over my project, 100% complete. Then, si proponent, being the representative, site CM, will conduct a punch listing, no, of your work. That is the quality control by observation na tinatawag natin. Because the product is completed. Ang sinasabi natin, QC is product-oriented, no? After the fact. So, tapos na, we conduct punch list. So, ano ba yan ng punch list? Quality control. Kasi to turnover mo na yung, after ng quality control, to turnover mo na yung unit sa owner, you know, sa proponent. Dapat masaya siya. So, we conduct punch listing final. This is the final stage. So, conduct final punch listing. First inspection, second inspection, first, no? Sasabihin natin tapos na. No? O yan, yung punch list natin. Okay. So, sabihin natin, nagawa na ni contractor yung punch list. No? Acceptance na tayo. We need to pa-accept na natin yung project natin sa proponent. This is now the release of the certificate of contract of completion and acceptance. Release na tayo ng certificate of completion and acceptance for the contractor. Okay? Tapos na. Accepted na yan. Garantisado na yan. Wala na yan. Wala na yan. Wala na yan. Quality issues. Okay? So, ang effect niyan is customer satisfaction na kaagad. Kasi acceptance na tayo eh. No? Wala nang problema. Okay. Any other questions? Any other questions before we proceed with warranty sa project construction life cycle?